Hey everyone, Iron Toast here. Thank you for watching. Today's video is about Black Widow and the Time Stone in the Save the Battlerealm quest. All right, this week's Ebony Maw quest to save the Battlerealm is with the Time Stone, and the Time Stone gets equipped to Black Widow. Now, for this particular quest, I had to level up my 4-star Black Widow because only a lucky few of us actually have a 5-star version. Her signature level's pretty low. It's around 20 or so. It's not that high. So let's give this epic mode a go. The first champion you have to fight here is King Groot. He has Special Lock 2, which is actually good for us. And I have willpower, so I gain life on that. Most of these battles are pretty straightforward. Unfortunately, when Kabam tweaked the difficulty, they made it a little too easy. You'll see this one's no exception. Actually, there is one fight that's kind of tough. So King Groot here, nothing special. Just remember when you're parrying his attack, when he's got Furies active, you have to react really quickly because otherwise he'll block you, or worse. Well, he won't parry you here, but he'll block you. Of course, watch out for his special one there. That's the one you want to try and bait because you can just all out evade. You'll notice here that when you're using Black Widow with the Time Stone, whenever you use a special, it actually doesn't drain your power immediately. It drains it over time, which is kind of cool because it allows you to drain, or excuse me, it allows you to reel off multiple specials off the same amount of power. And in case you didn't catch that at the end there, I had 100 cruelty buffs. So once you get Black Widow with the Time Stone ramped up, it is pretty nasty. What else does she do? She will nullify all of her debuffs whenever she crosses a bar of power. You'll definitely see that on the Void fight here in a little bit. So let's tackle Morningstar here. Normally Morningstar would make you bleed oftentimes when you attack her. You'll notice that because of Black Widow's duped ability, the subtlety ability, sometimes you will cancel out her defensive abilities. And when that happens, you'll see that I gain a little bit of power there. You'll see a passive power buff on me. It happened a minute ago. See if we can get it again. We're going to probably save up for a special 3 here. If you're quick enough, you can actually get the special 3 like twice in a row. I'm not sure if I caught any of those on video here, but I'm going to let her use her special first. There we go. I tried to evade, but I ended up blocking. So we're going to throw our special 3. Nice little animation, kind of classic. This one's been around since, I think, the beginning, Black Widow. I mean, I started the game after about a year, well, 9 months after it started. I'm going to try and get another special 3. I didn't quite have enough there. No big deal. The only downside to reeling off 2 specials is it drains your power faster than if you only did 1. But, so looking at it right now, kind of goofing around trying to evade her special 1. It is easier to evade. I kind of waited too long. I lost my cruelty buffs, but that's okay. We're still doing pretty decent on health ourselves anyway. Gonna do some little pretty aggressive fighting here. Gotta bait that special 2 now. There we go. Lots of dexterity there. We're back into buff mode. Got 4 here. See if we can get, there we go, some more 8, 16, 32. Yeah, once you get that ramp, once you get it going and it starts doubling like that, it gets over pretty quick. Next fight here is Void. kind of depends on how you manage his buff on you. By the way, he has Biohazard, which is kind of nasty. Now you do get to purify your own debuffs when you cross power. So if you play carefully enough, you can kind of manage the Biohazard that's coming at you as well as his own Void's normal debuffs. So I'm waiting here. I've got 9 hits, and then there we go. Now that he's got it on me, I'm going to cross over to 10 hits. There we go. All right, so there's a bleed. So now I'm going to quickly want to try and get to another bar of power. Yeah, I've got 2 bleeds. There we go. Both gone. His special 2 is also unblockable, so you got to make sure you're extra careful there. All right, so there we go. Cleared off that buff. Yeah, 32 cruelties. You just need 1 or 2 hits. Once you start doubling those cruelties, it gets over real fast. Okay, so the last fight. The last fight was actually pretty tricky, and I think it was inadvertently tricky. So the Ebony Maw, Black Widow has a tendency to auto-evade, which is normally good for you because you get some benefits from the Time Stone for that. But I find mixed with his Limber buff here, It really makes it to where your parries are kind of worthless pretty early on. So this was probably this is the trickiest fight with her. So we're gonna try and go in for some normal attacks here pretty early because the parries and the stuns are long enough, but you'll see that it gets a little tricky. So he's got the focus. What you really want to try and do here is get a heavy attack in there to break his focus. There it goes. You'll see what I'm talking about here in a second. There we go. See, that was that. That's where I struggled right there because he pushes you away a little bit. You've got that auto evade, which kind of pushes you away, and then it goes away so quickly. Plus the limber, it's really hard to counterattack. So I did find this a little bit difficult. At some point, I realized that the parries just weren't lasting long enough. So I'm gonna try and intercept with a heavy. It is tough, by the way. Kind of gave up on that at some point, you'll see. Totally missed all those. So now we're just gonna go back. Now we're just gonna try and intercept. That's the best we can do. First, we gotta bait out this special here. Kind of running out of room. Missed, of course, because I'm not using a science champion. That makes it a struggle. Is he gonna? Okay, let's try and get one more heavy in here, maybe. Intercept. All right, there we go. Let's get some intercepts in there. He does do degeneration on you sometimes, which is no fun. Yeah, this one was a pain. All right, there we get some intercepting there. Kind of being careful with intercepts here because he's got that special ready to go. All right, we got some distance. There we go. Let him do that. Excellent. You know, it's hard to tell. You know, you're kind of afraid to go in there with a combo because if you miss him on that first one, I personally kind of let up and don't do any more of a combo. We're probably gonna stick to intercepting as much as we can. There we go. One or two hits. Ooh, he got me there. Oh boy. If you have really good reflexes, you can auto evade with Black Widow like she does normally, and then attack right away. But man, it's tough. Plus, at this point in the battle, the limber has basically made all those, even those parries and stuns, kind of worthless. I've got some cruelty that helps a little bit. Refresh there. There we go. So yeah, that one did take. Like I said, that was a little tougher to get used to. That was my first time to try it, so thankfully we got through it without screwing up. So that's pretty much it. So fairly easy quest. You can do it with a maxed out 4-star Black Widow. Might be easier for you if you have a higher signature level. I don't know. But there you have it. Just know that you can nullify buffs. Excuse me, you can nullify debuffs when you cross your own bar of power. You can usually reel off multiple ones because of the way it drains instead of just instantly disappears. And then you can get it done. So that's it. That is Black Widow and the Time Stone. I hope that helped you guys. If you like this, do subscribe and hit that like button and share with your alliances if you think this is helpful. Appreciate it, guys. Bye.